Hey creative people, today I'm going to be painting these birch trees. So please subscribe, share, like, and
okay, so I have my canvas here. It's 30 by 15 centimeters. Actually, this is canvas board. So let's go through the palette. I'm going to be using titanium white, primary blue, primary yellow, primary red, burnt umber, rose, sienna, black, and middle green. So let's get started for the background. I'm gonna spray a little bit my canvas just to improve the flow. And for the background, to use this flat number 12 brush, dab it into the water and go with my green first. It's not that important because this part will be covered by leaves and branches. Adding just a little bit black to darken it up. Maybe a little bit blue. Yeah, like that color. So just walking in this phase somewhere about here. So about 1/3 of the canvas or so. Add a little bit blue here too. Just covering this white, simple as that, and not blending at all because we're going to have some variations there, and it's better to avoid that blending. These strokes will work for us later. Okay, so I'm taking green now, a little bit black. I'm gonna add this sienna and white. Maybe a little bit of the blue because of perspective and atmosphere influence there. So I didn't clean my brush, but there is still some back in there, but it's okay, it's really okay, because we are just walking in that. Okay, I'm gonna getting wider over there. Saturated colors in the front. Take the blue and umber. Okay, get back to that previous color with blue. Just lock it in. That's pretty much it. Sienna, it's seen with your brush. Smaller brush. This is number 7. Horizontal strokes with your canvas because we don't want to create a wall. It's a river. Add a little bit more black anvil. Side. In the pressure. Sienna. brush. It does barely touch the canvas. Details here because this is pretty far away, so just a suggestion. Green. Just slightly adding some variations there. Most of this will be covered by trees. Umber and wool. More on both sides. Okay, just to show you here, umber and wool on both sides. Here. here. Dark spots there, since I already got there. Blue, white, violet. Umber, because this is shallow water. See some dirt, especially here in the front. Some streaks, lights, darks, but keep in mind that the more vibrant and darker colors are in the front and in the back, lighter and less vibrant colors. And if you want a less vibrant color, you can just add or white. See? Color, in this case orange. Green to this because not reflective. Colors from the nature. Just be careful with measuring the time if you feel like paint is sticky and getting hard to blend or pull your color, just dry it first because you can pull your paint on the canvas. It's safer to just it's all about that. More layers you add, more depth. It's there because acrylics are transparent colors and but I'm gonna add that to the painting. A little bit of purple. Thank you.
let's try now. Okay, so I wanna do this more time for this because I'm gonna cover most of this background, so I'm gonna use flat brush. This is number 10 and just so now, important thing here is that you have enough paint on your brush and enough water. So I'm gonna spray my palette. Just, this is from bottle from body spray. I find it very, very good. Are pretty straight trees. Our trees are just that kind of tree, straight, and out of curves. See, I'm getting my bumping lines, so I'm gonna take more water and more paint. Thank you.
it's pretty same. Top and okay, I think maybe a little wider. Okay, that's good. This one is like this. Like purple color. Purple color. Okay, I think this is dry now. Let's add our bigger trees. Okay. Quite. Pressing real hard my brush to get this decline. Touch of blue. gonna mix a darker purple with umber and blue, like a grayish purple. Take my foam brush and add some. I'm curving these lines. using just quite a touch of blue. Just using light erasure very reflection from this leaves. Okay, quiet. Okay, this is too wet. We can work on this. Okay. highlights. Okay. Okay, let this dry. In the meantime, I'm gonna take my big round brush, take a little bit of blue and green. Create a deep green color. Just tapping. But not covering all this dark. Just tapping, and that's pretty making some birch leaves. Maybe touch it. Rosianna. Highlights on the leaves. But don't overdo it, we need it. Just adding some highlight leaves and make sure that I'm doing it. And I can think it's a good idea if I can pick slightly different color and go in different directions. Red to this, especially in this upper part, because there's less sun and red is opposite from the green color wheel, so it's going to that green down. It's so bright and saturated. So that's a good way to saturate your colors. Just use complementary color and it's gonna tone that. I think I'm gonna add with my dirty brush just blue. So to create kind of bluish those upper parts. Just to add depth. That in acrylics, it's all about layering. More layers, more depth. Because these are translucent colors and just try it. Don't believe me. Adding a little bit yellow. Every time changing a little bit it. Dark spots in this part because of this. Okay, I'm gonna leave it now and let's go and the first layer of grass here. You can use green. Fan brush. Okay. If you don't have your fan brush, don't worry, you can use just to create this. Especially here. Because this is further from the sun. Actually, here too.
part here. Just add some highlights. Maybe this is not the best brush for this, but it's okay. Match it with this. Bit green, but it's highlights. I'm using pure white now. Just pour that color in. Brush for this is flat brush because it can create a really sharp line with these brushes.
I'll take a little bit. Yellow and white. And add some spots. Because we have a lot of colors on these birch trees because they are really reflective because of their white color. Sienna. That yellowish greens. Actually, add a little bit of pink. Red with all this. This background, just this. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bit from Umber. White. Pretty much dry brushing here. Umber. Try it. Create kind of grayish blue. More burnt umber. Thank you. bark on the birch tree. Although this one doesn't help too much of this, just a few. Almost white, but it's not. There is a touch of blue in it. Umber.
need some. Thank you.
yellow and red. Good, take white. Just in this part, because here is really bright. And that's it. I'm done. I hope you like it. If you do, please subscribe, share, and like, and thank you for watching.